8-year-old child was with a white family, an African-American child with a white family, and got burned all over his body. Questions are still looming. Let me show you the picture of the young man, the media and family, they have provided the information. An Arkansas family is demanding answers and accountability after an 8-year-old child was severely burned. Jayceon Charles was at a friend's house in Warren, Arkansas in August, preparing to go to Magic Springs the next day. However, he left home with 80% of his body burned, according to his family. This kid and his friend were roasting hot dogs when the fire erupted. No one at the friend's home called or reported the incident. Are you hearing me? No one called or reported the incident. His family believes Jayceon's race played a role in the lack of urgency in his treatment and attention to his care. Let's go ahead and put up the picture of some of his burns. This 8-year-old kid was in the intensive care unit at Arkansas Children's Hospital, recovering from burns across the back of his body. The child had to be resuscitated twice. He is breathing through a tube connected to a ventilator. He has suffered brain damage, kidney failure, has undergone several surgeries. Doctors have had to remove 5 inches of his small intestine, and he's had a life-threatening infection called sepsis. Let me give you a little more background to this. His mother, Lakeisha Bellin, said her son called and hung up. His father called back and he was screaming. His parents rushed to the friend's home to find the child covered in Vaseline and plastic wrap. Nobody called 911. Nobody called. The third grader is now in the Arkansas Children's Hospital intensive care unit, continuing to recover. The child's father, Justin Charles, said they do not believe these injuries resulted from an accident. He wants his son to be made whole, to fully recover, but he also wants justice for his child. Here's the thing, there are other moving pieces to this story. We're gonna continue to follow this story. There's something here. You have a child who's literally suffering from significant burns that he could die from. And the family, they decide not to call the police, not to call the ambulance, not to call you, but your child calls you and hangs up. Do you think he voluntarily hung up? Do you think somebody hung the phone up for him? Please keep investigating this. And sir, Justin, please, as a father, I'm with you, brother. I'm a father, man. I can't imagine what you're feeling right now, but you're doing the right thing. Keep the pressure high, all right? Ben, thoughts here?
Yeah, I mean, like ultimately, they can say that the burns themselves were an accident, but you know what's not an accident? Not calling 911, not calling the parents, not doing something. Vaseline and plastic wrap, are you kidding me? Like, oh my goodness. Some of those infections probably were made worse by that, but like ultimately, this needs like real investigations to figure out what exactly was going on.
Well said, and we're gonna continue to follow this. Obviously, it is a developing story, and we are hopeful and prayerful that the young 8-year-old hero will thrive.